welcome back to this channel. I am here today to explain to you how to play poker. And I am talking about Texas Hold'em No Limit Poker today. I'm not gonna teach five card stud, seven card stud, Omaha. There's all sorts of kind of poker games out there, but I wanna explain to you how to play Texas Hold'em because that's, I think, the most popular version of poker being played out there today, and certainly the only one I really know how to play kind of okay. If you've never played poker before, I totally get how it's intimidating and scary, especially if you're a female, and I know that all of you are not females watching this video, but I know that a lot of females do watch this, and I just want to encourage you and say, if you have been intimidated to try and learn poker or feel like you can't be a part of it because it's the boys club or it's like too hardcore of a game, that's just simply not true, and you are just as capable as being good at poker as anybody else. So I just wanted to begin by explaining some really, really, really basic level stuff. So if you already know how to play poker, this video is not for you. You can probably just skip on to the next one where I will be going more in depth as this series goes on. Basically, if you've never played poker before, it's a game where everybody starts off with chips, whether it's just some sort of chip size, whether it's, if it's a cash game, that means that the chips in front of you represent a dollar amount. So if you have 10 $1 chips in front of you, that means you have $10 of chips in front of you. If you're in a tournament, then the chips in front of you aren't exactly representative of a dollar. So you might have like 20,000 chips in front of you that you paid $200 to have all of those 20,000 increments of chips, but you don't actually have $20,000 cash in front of you, if that makes sense. So sometimes when you guys see me talk about poker, I'll be like, oh, I had 170,000 chips. That does not mean $170,000 unless I was playing a cash game, and then I would be insane because I'm definitely never gonna play with $170,000 on the table. So anyways, that's kind of the difference there. So poker is a game where you have chips in front of you, and usually there's like four or more players playing in a table, and each player for Texas Hold'em is given two cards that nobody else should see. They should be hidden in front of you, and when you take a peek at them, you don't want anyone to see them. Because this is a game of kind of lying and secrecy, and you are trying to outsmart and out-strategize the people around you. Once everybody gets their cards, then something, there's a betting round that happens. So you look at your cards and you're like, I either like these cards, I don't like these cards, or I'm kind of indifferent about these cards. So I'll get more into the details of how this betting stuff, all of that works, but I just want to say that, like, once you get your cards, there's a round of betting. We'll just leave it at that, and I'll explain more later. Then what happens is the dealer will flip over cards that are essentially called the flop. So if you've ever heard anyone be like, oh, I bet this pre-flop, post-flop, oh, and then the flop came. The flop are the first three cards that are presented to you as the players from the dealer. Now, the thing about Texas Hold'em is those cards are going to be on the middle of the table. You've probably seen something more or less kind of similar to that. And those cards, everybody has access to. And at the end of a complete round of poker, you are going to be wanting to have the best five cards. No, but you only have two in front of you, but you're gonna eventually have five in front of you on the board that you get to choose three of to go with your hand. I know that sounds a little confusing, but let's just say, for example, you are dealt two aces in front of you. So these are the cards that are in front of you that nobody else can see. Then, by the end of the round, there's gonna be five cards face up that everybody can see and everybody can use. And if one of those cards is an ace face up, that technically means you have three aces. Because even though that ace on the board is not physically in your hand, you are allowed to use that ace on the board as a part of your hand. So now your two aces just became three, and they're that much stronger. So I know that's a little confusing when you actually don't have the cards in front of you, but just bear with me, and the more you hear me talk about this, the more you have cards in front of you, the more this is all gonna make sense. Because just when, like, you're learning anything, it can be very overwhelming to hear all the information at once, and then your brain's trying to sort what to deem as important information and what you shouldn't pay attention to now. Basically, just know that's kind of how a round in poker goes. You get dealt two cards, three cards end up being on the flop that everybody can see. There's another round of betting. Then another card, a fourth card, is presented to everybody on the board, and then there's another round of betting, and then the last card is presented, which is called the river, and that is the last card that will be shown. Then there's another round of betting there. Essentially, if you don't like the cards that are coming on the flop, and you don't really want to bluff, then you're gonna fold your hand. So folding means just taking yourself out of this round. It doesn't necessarily cost you anything. It means you're putting your hand down for this round, and you're gonna be dealt brand new cards the second this round is over and you're still in the game. So it's not taking yourself out of the game completely, it's just taking yourself out of that round. That's what's called folding. So folding your hand means getting yourself out of that particular round. Now, I haven't talked about yet what type of hands beat other hands. This is where the game really starts to take action. So you need to know, it's kind of like the rules. And basically there's a hierarchy of hands that beat other hands. And if it gets down to the river, that last fifth card, and you are against somebody else, you are hoping that you have the best hand here, meaning the hand that is in the highest of the hierarchy of the list that I am going to put right here, but also just talk about a little bit. And this is something, this list, I actually referred to a lot when I first started playing poker. I would have it on my phone so I could just like take a peek at it. But anyways, so the hierarchy goes, Royal Flush is the best hand in poker. So that means Ace, King, Queen, Jack, 10 of all the same suit. That's a royal flush, and that is the best hand that beats every hand in poker. The next is a straight flush. So that just means any five consecutive cards that go in a row that are all the same suit that are not starting with ace going down to 10. So even like king, queen, jack, 10, 9, all the same suit, that's still a straight flush. The next hand that is on the hierarchy is a four of a kind. So like I was saying before, if you had two aces in front of you and two came on the board eventually, that would mean you have four aces. Next on the list is a full house. So a full house is when you have three of any kind of card and two of another. So again, if you had three aces and two jacks, that would be a full house. If you had three jacks and two aces, that would also be a full house. Does that make sense? So basically, three of any one kind of card matched with two of any other kind of card is a full house. And it's not suit related, it's only number related. So, by the way, and I'm assuming you know this, but a suit is diamonds, hearts, clubs, or spades. That's a suit. And then after the full house, it is a flush. This is when you have all of the same suit, but the numbers don't matter at all. So you could have ace, seven, five, jack, two, but if they're all diamonds, that's a flush. Or if they're all spades, that's a flush. And the numbers do not matter. That's why when a straight flush is so good, because it's all the same suit, all the same numbers in consecutive order, or all the numbers in consecutive order. So that's what makes a straight flush so powerful, because you've got the numbers and the flush aspect of it. So underneath a flush is a straight. So a straight is, again, any numbers in consecutive order, five cards in consecutive order. The suits don't matter in a straight. Whoever has the highest straight wins. So if I have a straight that consists of 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 random suits, and my opponent has 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, my opponent would beat me because they have a higher straight, because their straight goes from up till 8, and my straight only went up to 7. It's all about the hierarchy here. It's all about who has the highest hand. Straight versus a straight, whoever has the highest number wins. All right, and then right after a straight, it goes three of a kind, two of a kind, high card. So essentially, if nobody has any pairs, nobody has a straight, a flush, nothing, it goes down to the highest card. So the highest possible card is an ace. So if nobody really hits anything on their board or has a pair in their hand, then if someone has an ace, that person wins. So that's just like a couple of the super, super basics about poker that I wanted to talk about in this episode. In the next episode, I'm going to be explaining to you the different actions that take place in a hand of poker. So the dealer, what they do, the small blind, the big blind, the actions that take place, an order of everything. And so now that you have a grasp on the hands and which one's more powerful than the other, and kind of just the general order of how poker goes, hopefully moving on to the next video, you'll be able to understand a little bit more of what I'm talking about. But yeah, thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions about anything I said today, if that didn't make sense, if it didn't make sense, just let me know. I'm gonna start answering your questions at the ends of these lessons, these videos, because why not? So let me know if you have any. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Turn notifications on. I know it's been kind of a dead channel for a while, but I hope that you are enjoying this series, and yeah. All right. Bye.